the equity market melt up back to the denser, deeper market of fixed income and foreign exchange?
Yeah, well, I think the melt-up has certainly been helped by the melt-up in bond prices. So the fact that the 10-year has been hovering, you know, close to 2.5% has been, I think, extremely helpful for the equity market. Keep in mind, when the Fed funds were roughly around zero, for that long stretch, the average 10-year yield was 2.5%. So we've got a lot of effective back-end monetary easing.
Now, you know, Kane has gone at the Fed. Stephen Moore has gone at the Fed. I sent a note to President Trump last night and said he ought to think about appointing Friedrich Hayek. Let's go off Friedrich Hayek right now. Mr. Hayek has been passed away for a few years, folks. Let's go Friedrich Hayek. You have to clear markets. Are we in this jam, whether it's greater EU banking, the unfolding of Italy and Greece, and all the other big picture issues, because we're afraid on a Hayekian basis to clear markets, to solve things, and move on?
Tom, it's a big question there, but I think you're hitting on a very sensitive point, which is that central banks have been babysitting markets for a long, long time.
Can we bronze that quote, please? That may be, you know, December 31 quote. Babysitting, go.
And we've been very, very afraid of any of the cleansing that relates to any growth slowdown. And hence, we've had, you know, things like the Greenspan put, the Yellen put. And more recently, of course, we've had what was seen as a Powell put. And it's not just the central banks. It's authorities elsewhere in the world that have picked up on this. The Chinese, for example, they have sort of underwriting growth effectively to keep growth around 6%. But you're seeing distortions all over the place, things that we could never have imagined, where central banks are buying assets and distorting credit and equity. Yes, I think you're absolutely right. A little bit of cleansing would be no bad thing. Not least, given where we're at, I think we should celebrate where we're at. We're 10 years into recovery, a recovery which has gone extremely well, things considered.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but so, Alan, what are you telling us? That it needs to be rethought?
So I agree with this guy. The babysitting of the central banks is going to keep the stock market up. It's going to allow the bond market to continue to chug along. And it's going to keep cryptocurrency not that interesting. So in my personal opinion, until this trend changes and the babysitting stops, it's going to be really, really hard to see some sort of market correction. And I don't really see crypto doing much unless regulation news is passed or some major development comes through. But let me know your thoughts on this and what you guys think of the economy, and I will talk to you guys soon.